Hello viewers, myself Dr. Nandit Kumar Agarwal, consultant pediatrician at IHR Hospital, Varanasi, Guwahati. Today I am going to discuss an important topic for every new mother's life, that is breastfeeding. So let's hope sharing my knowledge with all the mothers will be helpful for them. As you all know, breastfeeding provides optimal nutrition for the baby and it has several benefits for the mother and the baby as well as the society. But for a new mother, it's often a challenge. Even WHO and the various pediatric association has advocated exclusive breastfeeding for 6 months. After that, breastfeeding will continue 1 year or beyond. But often the new mothers face very new challenges. They have various doubts in their mind regarding breastfeeding. And to clear these doubts, we have society as well as a very crucial role to play. So the motivation and support to the mother is necessary for providing solution to all these difficulties. So now let's discuss about the common difficulties one by one. The first common difficulty on the mother's face is that my milk is not enough. That is not enough milk. So first thing is that mother should be reassured that her milk is enough or not. If the baby is healthy, actively crying baby, normal baby, baby's weight gain is adequate according to her growth pattern, and baby is passing urine more than 5 to 6 times in a 24 hours period, the mother can be reassured that her milk is enough, so nothing to worry. If actually milk is not enough, then we have to find out the reasons, what are the reasons for milk being not being enough. So the first common reason is that the mother is not giving the feeding in the required time period, that is feeding is not often enough. Ideally, a mother should feed her baby every 2 to 3 hourly and on demand also. If the baby cries, before 2 to 3 hours, baby have to feed. And with correct position and frequent feeding is given, then the milk will definitely come out. Because the more the mother feeds to the baby, the more the milk production increases. The second reason being maybe that the mother is giving very too short feed. That means mother is giving for feeding for few minutes, then stop breastfeeding. Then the mother also may feel that my milk is not enough. So ideally, what should be the duration of feeding? The duration of feeding that should be the as long as the baby sucks and swallow the breast. Ideally, if a baby sucks normally, the baby can feed up to 20 to 25 minutes. So when the baby stops feeding and releases the breast and goes to sleep, the mother should think that my baby has got the enough milk. So the duration of feeding should be very important. Then the third reason may be because there are poor attachment, that is known as latching. If the mother's position and the baby's position is not comfortable, or the baby's mouth attachment with the mother's breast is not appropriate, the mother may have a feeling of not enough milk. So proper positioning and correction, this can be rectified. The second most common difficulty especially new mothers feel is that my baby is not taking feeding well. So if a mother feels that her baby is not feeding well, at first we have to see whether the baby is sick or well baby. If a baby is sick, then we have to consult your doctor immediately. But if a baby is healthy baby, crying, normal, actively moving baby, then you have to find out the reason why the baby is not feeding well. The first and most important reason may be the ineffective latching. That means if the baby's positions and attachment to the mother's breast is not good, not correct, then this is the most common problem. So how to rectify this? Both mother and baby should be in a comfortable position. They can be in a sitting position or in a lying down position. The baby's head, neck and back should be in the same plane, and the baby's face should face the mother's face. Then after proper positioning of the baby, the baby's mouth should be, corner of the mouth should be touched by the mother nipple. Then the baby will open the mouth. As soon as the baby opens the mouth, the mother should introduce her breast nipple along with the areola, that means the black portion surrounding the nipple, that both the parts should be introduced in the baby's mouth. And when the baby starts sucking, if the proper latching is there, the mother will feel no pain and the mother can also hear the swallowing sound by the baby. So if these positions can be corrected, the latching can be proper and the baby will get the correct feeding. The second most common reason for this being the mother is giving scheduled feeding. That means mother is giving scheduled feeding means every 3 hourly or 4 hourly mother is giving the schedule. That should not happen. Baby should be given feeding on demand also. Ideally, every 2 to 3 hours baby should be given feeding. If baby cries before that, mother should also feed, and every feed should be 15 to 20 minutes long. The next common reason for being not getting the right feeding because of the use of pacifiers. Pacifiers are given, sometimes given by the mother or the caregiver in the family if the baby is excessive crying. But that should not be practiced because it gives a faulty sense of sucking. And the after that, baby is not able to suck the breast properly. Then sometimes what happens, if the baby is excessively sleepy, the mother may feel that my baby is not getting enough milk. So baby should be awake after every 2 to 3 hours and try to give the breastfeeding for another 10 to 15 minutes. If even after the trying, baby is not getting the sucking the milk, then you can try another again after 30 minutes to 1 hour after. So by this way, we can allay the anxiety of the mother that my baby is not feeding well. Then the third most difficult is that mother feels that I get hurt when I feed the baby. That means the problem with the nipple. The common reasons for being maybe the nipple pain. Why the nipple pain occurs? It may be occurs because of the incorrect position. As I have told already, the position should be perfect, the latching should be perfect, there will be no nipple pain. Second common problem with the nipple may be sore nipple or what you know as crack nipple. The main common reason for the crack or sore nipple is the ineffective attachment. You could give the good attachment, the problem will be solved. The other ways to prevent the sore nipple is that before applying the baby to the breast, take few drops of breast milk and apply to the breast, then allow the baby to feed with proper position. Even if after that the sore nipple happens, then mother is feeling pain, the breast which is having sore nipple, that can be rested, and that means baby can be allowed to direct feed in the another breast, and the breast in which pain is there, mother can express the milk and feed by the spoon for next 2 to 3 days. Then when the pain decreases and the nipple heals, then mother can feed the baby with the both the breast. And if the pain is more, you have to consult your doctor. Some medications or local things are there that can be applied 2 to 3 times in a for a few days, and the problem will be solved. So sore nipple can be solved like this. So by this way, the pain during feeding can be eliminated. Another most common difficulty mothers feels that breast engorgement. What does it mean? Mothers feels pain and says my breast is full. So what might be the reason for that? If the mother is not giving regular feeding, proper feeding, there is more milk production, then there will be fullness of breast. If baby is not feeding in proper position, there will be breast fullness. So how to solve this problem? The mother should give every 2 to 3 hourly feeding with proper position. Even if after that problem is not solved, if the mother feels more pain, then the breast should be, milk should be expressed manually or by breast pump, and feeding should be given by the spoon. When the baby sucks normally, then baby can be allowed to direct breastfeeding. By this way, we can decrease the pain and swelling of the breast. And another common practice can be done is that if pain is more, mother can take simple paracetamol tablets or consult the doctor. Or sometimes the warm pack application, soaking a towel or cotton cloth in a warm water and applying over the breast, can relieve the pain of the breast engorgement. So by this way, you can solve the problem of fullness of the breast. Then sometimes mother also complains that my baby is crying excessively when I feed him. See, this is the normal phenomenon in first 3 to 4 days after birth. Because first 3 to 4 days after birth, baby also have emotionally rather than hunger. That does not mean that baby is not getting enough milk. If your baby is sucking every 2 to 3 hourly and baby is, even though baby is crying but passing even normally, you should not be think of that. Because sometimes there is emotional need of the baby also. So excessive crying does not always mean that baby is not getting enough milk. And lastly, I am going to highlight a special situation for the twin mothers, my mother who has delivered the twins baby. So mother should always be reassured that a mother practically can feed both the babies. It does not mean that I have twin babies, I may not have enough milk. Don't think like that. A mother can even feed 3 babies at a time. So what should be the proper feeding guideline? That both the babies should be fed simultaneously in both the breasts. That will, as we know, the more the baby sucks, the more the milk will produce. So if both the babies are fed simultaneously, then milk production will be more. And the alternate breast should be given to the alternate baby. Suppose first baby, in the this feeding, first baby is given the right breast and the second baby is given the left breast. So in the next feeding, what you should do? The first baby should be given the left breast and the second baby should be given the right breast. So that both from the stimulus, the reflexes from both the breast goes to the mother's central part, and that produces more milk. And there are certain position the mother may feel that there is a football position holding both the baby like football and feeding both the babies can solve this problem. And to be successful breastfeeding, whether in a twin baby or whether in a single baby, the most crucial role is to be played by the healthcare worker during first to 3-4 days of hospital stay And after discharge at home, the mother definitely need the support by the family and the society for the breastfeeding to be successful and less painful. Because breastfeeding is a joy for a mother. So mother should enjoy the breastfeeding and they should enjoy the motherhood. So I wish all the mothers to be happy feeding.